Female chemical contraception has become commonly used since its introduction over 60 years ago. However, there are currently no forms of chemical contraception available to males. Recently, a new research paper published in Science, one of the most respected scientific journals, set out to change this. While clinical trials for a handful of male hormonal contraceptives are ongoing, there is still a lack of small molecules which could allow for contraception for a well-validated target. This team of researchers looked at using a non-hormonal approach to allow for male contraception. To do this, they focused their efforts on the kinase enzyme STK33. Kinases are one of the most common targets of pharmaceutical drugs, with an estimated 30% of research worldwide dedicated to these enzymes. Kinases are enzymes which catalyze the phosphorylation of various biological substrates, which is an important process in cellular signaling and regulation. They are primarily targeted for the treatment of cancer, but their function extends beyond this. STK33 stands for serine threonine kinase 33 and is found in almost all species. It is highly expressed in sexual organs and has been shown to be important for male fertility in both mice and humans. When the gene for this enzyme is removed through genetic modification in mice, they become infertile. Humans with mutations to this gene have also been shown to be infertile. Importantly, these men and mice are otherwise normal and healthy, showing that this could be a safe way of targeting male contraception. The researchers suggested that if a small molecule could be used to inhibit this enzyme, it would have the same effect as the removal or mutation of the gene, leading to a contraceptive effect. To find a chemical starting point to develop an STK33 inhibitor, the researchers used DNA-encoded library technology. These libraries contain billions of unique molecules which can be screened against the STK33 protein. The molecules which bind the strongest can be selected for by washing away molecules which bind weakly. The chemical structure of these molecules can be identified using the DNA tag, which acts as a barcode and relates to a specific molecule. If you would like to know more about how DNA-encoded library technology works, let me know in the comments and I can go through this in a future video. The molecules identified through this process were then synthesized without the DNA tag and retested to confirm that they bind to STK33 and also have an inhibitory effect. The screen revealed two hits, with the only difference being the length of the linker used to attach them to the DNA. Both of these molecules were 10 to hundreds of times more potent than any previous STK33 inhibitors published, but they had poor properties, such as high molecular weight, racemic chiral centers, and low metabolic stability in human liver microsomes. The medicinal chemistry efforts first focus on trimming down the linker region of the molecule and synthesizing the individual enantiomers. These changes showed that the R enantiomer was 8 times more potent than the original hit and 200 times more potent than the S enantiomer. However, these changes did not lead to an increase in metabolic stability, which was still an issue. The structure-activity relationship around this molecule was studied to identify key binding interactions. Replacement of the dimethylamine with either the primary amine or the alcohol reduced potency. Methylation of the indazole led to complete loss of activity, showing that this group is probably involved in a hydrogen bonding interaction. Variation of the biphenyl structure showed that the ortho arrangement was ideal, with potency decreasing from the meta to the para. The acetylene linker was also shown to be key, with both changes leading to a loss of activity. This SAR data was confirmed when the X-ray crystal structure of the lead molecule bound to STK33 was determined, which is the first of its kind. This data showed that the dimethylamine forms a hydrogen bond interaction with an aspartic acid residue, which is normally involved in magnesium ion binding. The rest of the pyrrolidine interacts with the protein through van der Waals interactions. The key role of the indazole was identified as both accepting and donating hydrogen bond interactions with the backbone of the protein. The initial molecules were synthesized starting from this indazole ester core, substituted in the free position with a bromine. This allowed for a Sonnegashiro reaction to install the acetylene biphenyl group. Ester hydrolysis and amide coupling using HATU completed the synthesis. The group then moved to a second method, starting with the iodoester core, and first protecting the indazole with a THP group, presumably to reduce side products in the Sonogashira reaction. The ester could then be hydrolyzed, allowing for the amide coupling to take place, with the deprotection of the THP group under acidic conditions as the final step. Further developments of this molecule led to the creation of CDD2807, the key molecule in this research. It had a similar level of potency to the previous lead molecule, but had vastly improved metabolic stability. To test the selectivity of this molecule against kinases other than STK33, a screen against 192 kinases was carried out. CDD2807 bound to STK33, the strongest out of any of the kinases. It also showed some binding to other kinases, such as SLK4 and SLK2, which have similar binding sites to STK33. CDD2807 still showed a 9-fold or greater selectivity towards STK33 over other kinases. This molecule was taken forward into testing in mice, which were subjected to two different dosing protocols. The experiments involved dosing the male mice with CDD2807 and then measuring the number of pups produced by the female mice. In both protocols, CDD2807 significantly reduced the number of pups after 1 month, and a complete contraceptive effect was achieved after month 2. Importantly, during this time the mice were shown to be healthy, with no changes to their sexual organs or weight. Almost no CDD2807 could be found in the brain, showing that it does not cross the blood-brain barrier, which is important in controlling unwanted side effects. When treatment of these mice was stopped, they regained the same level of fertility as the control group within 1 to 2 months, showing that these contraceptive effects can be reversed. While this data is promising, there are still several challenges to overcome. One problem is that this molecule has very poor oral bioavailability, with the compound needing to be injected into the abdomen of the mice during the studies. This needs to be addressed if the medication were to be given as an easily taken pill, like most contraceptives. Clearly, this study is only in mice, and while animal models are frequently used and relatable to humans, this is not always the case. The next logical step would be to move to non-human primates, whose biology even more closely resembles that of humans. The authors commented that they hope this work will act as a benchmark for future work in this area, with suggested modifications to the molecule which could be used to further increase selectivity towards STK33. The crystal structure generated will also no doubt be extremely useful to developing this molecule, or similar ones which have better pharmacokinetic properties. Thank you for watching this video. Let me know what your thoughts are on this new research. If you want to support this channel, giving this video a like and leaving a comment is the easiest way you can help. As always, references used can be found in the description.